Many pastors are wanting me to teach them how to go up into the presence of Jesus, to sit with Jesus, to talk to Jesus, to literally go into His arms, to sit before God, to hear His voice, to feel His presence. Jesus said that because of His death, we can now go before the Father. We were never allowed to do that before. So today, an unprecedented video of how to go be literally with the Lord. This is not for those who don't care about Jesus. This is not for those who just like experimenting with things of the spiritual world. This is for Christians. And if you mess with it, you'll be messing with God Himself, because this is probably the most serious lesson I have ever taught. But I lay the responsibility into your hands now. So if you want to learn, truly want to learn, how to be totally close with the Lord, how to use this gift that the Lord Himself taught me, then sit back and let me teach you. The first thing to do, find a quiet place. Find a place where there is no one around. A place where you can be yourself, whether that be in your bedroom or out in nature. This is where I like to pray, one of the places, on this rock overlooking this hole. Wherever your place that you choose, you must be a place where you can totally let go. Relax. Know that you will not be disturbed. Find a place of total peace where you feel safe and you won't be bothered. Find a place, hopefully in the sunlight, where you can feel the warmth of the sun. This is one of my favorite places, this golf course. Quiet, surrounded by nature, and right now no one in sight. Let go of all your fears. Quiet your mind. Quiet your heart. Listen to nature. Just let go. Let go and breathe. Breathe, just relax. Feel every worry just disappear. Just quiet the mind. This is critical. You must quiet the mind. Let everything go. If you have to tell yourself to be quiet, then do so. But the first part is to quiet your mind. The second is to quiet your heart. The Lord said, before you come to me, quiet your heart, quiet your mind. There's too much chatter. We can't hear the Lord if we're chattering away. Next, get into a comfortable position. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath in and release it. Now see yourself, your spirit. See it leave your body and go up to heaven. Just go up, just keep going up. And if you can't go up, it means you have too much fear and anger. You can't go up and sit at the right hand of the Father to sit with Jesus if you have too much fear and anger. So just release it. Release it. Just keep releasing it. And don't go into some mystical light or things like that where there is no definition of God and Jesus. This is to go up into the presence of Jesus. This is not some Buddhism practice or anything else. This is a Christian practice which Paul himself did. He said many times, I don't know whether I'm in my body or out of my body, but I'm present with the Lord. He said to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So just keep your eyes on the Lord and just draw into Him. Just go up into Him. Leave all your cares. Leave your body. Leave even the thought of your body behind. Just focus on the Lord and go into Him. Sometimes it's helpful to sit in the sunlight and just close your eyes and be drawn up into that light of Jesus. Drawn up into that light of heaven. Just see yourself going into the light of heaven. And if you find you can't do this, then come back and just sit and close your eyes and see Jesus stand before you. See Jesus just standing before you and come into His arms. Whether as an adult or a little child, often I like to see myself as a little girl and I just crawl into Jesus' arms and He holds me. He holds me when I'm sad. When I want to rejoice, I take His hand and we dance. The Lord loves it when we dance with Him. Jesus, He loves to sing and dance. Jesus did not walk through this world as a depressed, angry man. He walked through it with a spirit of love, of joy, of peace. He often went to parties and festivities. He was filled with hope and joy. And we must be too. What do you really think that God meant when He said, come into me, come into my arms? Do you think He just meant that facetiously? Because I can guarantee you He meant it literally, just like the Bible. We're to stand on the words literally. That's the rock underneath our feet. God means literal things when He says them. Some of you may be thinking that this is evil, that this is something that the mystics do. But let me ask you this, where do you think they got it from? God designed everything. He designed us to walk in the Spirit. How else do you think you're going to walk in the Spirit unless you leave the flesh behind? What do you think St. Francis of Assisi did when he was praying in a church and yet his body, he appeared on a battlefield and turned back the attackers? People, we need to learn everything that God has designed us to be. There is nothing evil about this as long as we go to Jesus. We don't go into some other world or some other God. We have to go into Jesus. We have to go into the presence of God. Not into just a light. Not another Shirley MacLaine. We're to go into the presence of Jesus. Let me ask you this. How do you think that I know the Lord so well? How do you think that I hear God so clearly? How do you think that I have won favor with the Lord? It is because ever since I've been a child, ever since I was 5 years old, and my mother had died, and my father was in Africa on a medical mission trip, I ran to God, calling Him Daddy. How could a little child call God Daddy? Children like to go into arms. They like to be held. How would I know this? How was I able to talk to God all of my life and see great miracles? And every time I died, He just kept bringing me right back. Why do you think the Lord told me to paint Him? Why did Jesus say, because you have seen me, you must paint me in all my glory? I am returning soon and my people are not prepared for my return. You have seen me. Paint me as I am, not as I was. Before I was a lamb. But when I return, I will be a lion. I will return as I am, king, king of all. Why do you think Jesus told me to paint Him? Unless I had seen Him, truly seen Him. Do you know what it's like to wake up in the middle of the night and to see 5-foot crosses glowing in your room, glowing of a light not from this world, and a peace not from this world, cover you? And when you lay back down, you see Jesus standing beside your bed, and He smiles. Do you know what that feels like?